This is my fucking way. This is how I win.
Yeah, second Warner Brothers.
Damn, it's definitely been a minute, and not much has changed really, except that comic book media surprisingly has seemed to have gotten worse since I stopped following it. Let's be real, it was mostly mid to bad for a while. We were just kinda waiting for it to finally tip into actual garbage territory. And safe to say, we're here, baby.
Why don't you just give me a bottle of scotch and a handgun to blow my fucking head off.
So before I get into it, what even is this video? I guess you can call it like an update or a catch-up of sorts. As you might know or might not know, because this is your first time seeing me, if it is, hi, I'm Tex. I followed comic book movies and news for years, and much longer before I even did it for YouTube. And about a year ago, I tapped out, and I was just done. Black Adam was one of the last comic book movies I saw in theaters. But don't get me wrong, it wasn't the driving force for my decision to finally leave. Comic book movies were already pretty bad at that point. And at the beginning of 2023, I just said fuck it and moved on, really. So here I am now, more cynical than ever, taking a look at the current state of comic book media, and just kind of laughing at it really, about its downfall and drastic dip in quality. So let's start with the big one. Look, I don't give a fuck, nigga, please believe me. Now I've been saying the MCU has been mid for quite a while, for years really, but I guess everybody else is starting to catch up to that. So the MCU has finally been seeing some diminishing returns on their movies, with Ant-Man not doing so well, and the reception from their shows haven't been that good, at least amongst the people who aren't paid to watch the damn things. And honestly, none of their future projects look that promising. I mean, the Marvels? You fucking kidding me? And according to some articles, even that has a super low projection for its opening weekend at the box office. But let's circle back to the shows. This might be controversial, but there hasn't been a good one yet, and certainly none worth finishing. Pretty sure they're gonna still be telling people to watch them all, cause you gotta see them all to understand the story. But man, when you actually look back at the MCU, that shit was like never really true. Like, you aren't missing much if you skip the Ant-Man movies, or Captain Marvel, or Iron Man 2. But they're gonna keep saying that to convince people to watch all these fucking shows somehow. And I almost feel sorry for the people who are actually convinced by this. Yeah, so honestly, the MCU is still pumping out shit like it's going out of style, so no surprise there. And the quality has been drastically just getting worse and worse. So again, no surprise there. But they're just now starting to get pushback, and I'm just sitting here wondering, what took people so damn long? And now as for DC, well, I used to give a fuck, now I can give a fuck less. So these latest batch of DC movies, let's be honest, do they even matter? Not really, because they already said they're gonna reboot it in the near future with James Gunn at the helm. So what does it matter? I guess because they had most of these movies in production for years, so don't wanna let all that money go to waste. But not like it mattered, because no one's seen these damn movies. The Flash, bomb. Blue Beetle and Shazam also underperformed. So much so that they were actually made available to rent from home less than a few weeks after it was released in theaters. Hell, they were still in theaters when you could rent them. Made pirating them a hell of a lot easier, not gonna lie. Now, out of all three of these, I've only seen The Flash, at least in its entirety. So I guess I'll give you like a quick review. I cannot stand like the fucking Paralympics. Yeah, it sucked. Now, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. It had a few moments that were kind of funny, or at least a little bit creative. But everything else just fucking sucked. Supergirl and Zod's return are completely underwhelming. The villain was so lackluster, and I kind of forgot about him. Until closer to the end when he makes his second appearance, and they reveal who he is. I swear, I forgot like all about him. He only has like one scene before then. Honestly, Michael Keaton as Batman was the best part. He had some of the best scenes, and some of the best action sequences. Oh, I almost forgot to mention, this movie looked like shit. Seriously, it looks just like the trailers that came out months before the movie did. It's kind of embarrassing, to be honest. Then again, this is almost like an industry standard at this point. Outside of like the Batman, most of these current comic book movies just look awful. Doctor Strange 2 was actually visually creative. That's because the goat Sam Raimi was involved, so you know. I guess I could go into more depth and detail, but I'll be honest with you, man, it's just not worth it. I don't care enough. This movie isn't worth that much effort. I care about as much as the studio that released this movie. And I would say just go watch a review, but I respect your time too much to even recommend doing that. Because it's more than likely going to be a video that's too damn long for its own good, explain shit that doesn't matter, just so the narrator can basically just beat off into the microphone. So I'm gonna save you a lot of time. I don't need an hour, I don't need 30 minutes, I don't even need 10 minutes. The Flash is bad. Is it as bad as most expected? Probably not, but it's still bad. Moving on.
I prefer boys.
Now as for Shazam and Blue Beetle, I was interested in seeing them, but after seeing the trailers and various clips, they just didn't seem that appealing. I mean, parts of it seemed pretty cool, but nothing that really made it seem worth spending 2 hours of my life in a theater for. I might stream it, but probably not anytime soon. But definitely before the end of the year, because I got something else planned. The only DC movie or comic book movie in general that I'm looking forward to is Aquaman 2. That's because I loved Aquaman 1, and I also love James Wan. The guy is one of my top 5 favorite directors. And just judging from the trailer, it looks like it's keeping much of the same tone and style of the first first film, which I absolutely loved. And not to mention, I'm pretty certain this would probably be the least affected DC movie, just because it's James Wan, so I don't think Warner Bros. Would really tell him what to do considering how much money he's brought in for that company. Not only with Aquaman, but with the Conjuring universe. Though I did hear about some reshoots and some additional scenes with Ben Affleck's Batman, but then I heard those were taken out. But regardless, I'm still very much looking forward to this one. And that's just because I have faith in James Wan. And then after it's released, that'll be the last of the DCEU movies, and then we'll be going into the James Gunn universe. So hopefully we can end on a high note at least. And that's the majority of stuff that I want to talk about, but before I finish this section off, I know there are a few things outside of the DC / MCU realm that I might as well address too. Starting with The Boys spinoff, Gen V. Yeah, I don't care. Oh yeah, and then there's that new Kraven the Hunter movie coming out, the newest entry into the Venom universe. Yeah, I still don't care. Now I know some people might be saying I'm a bit too harsh, and I'm just bashing the medium, and yeah I am. But I'm being harsh because I know these movies and projects can be better. Hell, I've seen them do it. And we've been at the point where they're just not even trying anymore, and everything is just derivative. Those of you who watched me in the past might be thinking I'm being more of a prick than usual, and it's cause I'm done giving them the benefit of the doubt, and just calling it how it is. My faith and optimism in this media is just gone, and I'm tired of people fooling themselves into thinking, wait, this one will actually be good, give it another chance. Well, they're mostly on a losing streak, and they've proven that it's almost never good. At best, they're like, what, decent or not that bad? Or maybe they're entertaining to a degree, but is that what's really acceptable these days? Definitely doesn't make them good. Honestly, I feel bad for the people who keep watching this stuff and just hoping that it's gonna get good again. For a while when I was following this stuff, I tried to remain optimistic and hopeful, but that's all gone now. They gotta earn it back. And honestly, just looking at this shit, that doesn't seem to be happening anytime soon. Look, I'm 29, I've been watching this shit my whole life. I see its ups, I see downs. And seeing the direction they've been going in for the last, what, 3, 4, 5 years, I don't feel like I have time to waste. I'm tired of cape shit and looking forward to it crashing. So until that happens, I'm gonna keep doing what I was doing and just ignoring this shit. Okay, yeah, so enough of that. Moving on.
Flush that turd down the drain!
Also, Across the Spider-Verse was mid.
What's going on? What the fuck did I do wrong?
Alright, so you're probably thinking, what the hell do you like then? What's been keeping you busy? Well, since this is kind of a ranty, rambling video anyway, I might as well tell you. So what's been keeping my attention, for the most part, is anime and manga. Now, I watched anime back in the day, back when you used to get bullied for liking it. I fell off of it sometime in 2015-2016, but over the past year, I've been just watching primarily anime, and I gotta say, best decision I've ever made. Shit's all around just so much better. I'm not gonna argue with you about it, I'm just telling you how it is. And when I'm not watching anime, then I'm usually just reading manga. And let me tell you have no idea how good it feels to read something that's actually good, because I sure as hell haven't been getting that from American comics recently. Hell, for like a decade almost. That's right, you thought we were done talking about cape shit? Nah, strap in, let's get going. You ain't done the work. So to put it bluntly, manga is curb stomping American comics. And that isn't an opinion, that's literally a fact. Have you checked the numbers? Read the articles? Manga is outselling American comics by a crazy margin. It's not even close. And yes, that's for here in North America. American comics, you know, home turf. Hell, in 2020 alone, Demon Slayer sold, what, 80 million copies? That was more than all the other comics released that year in America combined. And in 2021, in total, comic books generated $2 billion in America, with manga making up 1.47 billion of that. So, 3/4 of all the sales of comic books in America in 2021 were Japanese manga. Hell, look at the numbers that some of the newer manga are putting out. Chainsaw Man passed 24 million total sales. Jujutsu Kaisen, over 80 million before season 2 even came out. Or hell, look at something a little bit older like One Piece. It officially passed Batman and Superman in total copies sold. And Batman and Superman had a 50-year head start. American comics wish they were pulling these type of numbers. Hell, you actually don't even have to go online to see this stuff. Just go to your local major retailer like Barnes & Noble or Books A Million. The manga section just dwarfs the comic book section. Most of the time, the comic book section is just a few tables or racks. And let's be honest, the only comics that are doing well are just reprints of older graphic novels from decades ago. And the only new shit that seems to be getting any attention are like smaller indie stuff, like Eric July's comics, for example. Each one had a pre-order campaign that did really well, one with 40,000, the other with 20,000. Hell, the American comic book industry is doing so bad that some companies are downsizing or outright just shutting down, because the shit just isn't selling. I know some some people might be thinking that just because manga has a lot higher sales doesn't necessarily mean that it's better, and that's true to a degree, but what it does tell us is what people are actually liking and what they're willing to spend their money on. And American comics just isn't that appealing to the vast majority of people. And this isn't even an argument about like physical media dying. These manga sales prove that that's simply not true. It's clearly the content of American comics that's not appealing. That's what people don't like, amongst a few other things. And you know what? Might as well go into those things now. So let me tell you why manga is knocking American comics dick in the dirt.
How much money you got? A lot. How many problems you got? A lot. How many people done doubted? A lot. Left you out to rot? A lot.
Now these would be some pretty rapid-fire reasons for what manga is doing differently, and not really a deep breakdown. There are videos already discussing this topic that's been out for years actually, so I'm not saying anything new, or anything you probably haven't heard before. But still, let me start listing off some reasons. I'll start with the obvious one, accessibility and low barrier of entry. You see, 9 times out of 10, if you see a manga or an anime that interests you, and you want to read it, you know where you start? Chapter 1. It's that simple. And in comics, you don't really get that, especially in the big ones like Marvel and DC. There are dozens, if not hundreds, of different stories, reboots, alternate versions, limited runs, one-shots, that trying to figure out where to start can be overwhelming. Now, a while ago, I made a few videos talking about good places to start for certain heroes, and those are some pretty fun videos, but the fact that those videos exist kind of proves my point. There is so much, and some things are connected while others aren't, there's crossover stories with different heroes, hell, there's crossover events, it just makes following everything a chore. Now, of course, this isn't always bad, because some great stories came decades after the character's original premiere, but it still doesn't change the fact that it's kind of a mess, and this still goes on today. Several writers and artists are given a character to do a run with, and then it's dropped to hand off to somebody else. There are exceptions to this, of course. Invincible and The Walking Dead are examples of long-run stories in American comics that are just one giant story. But let's be honest, those are few and far between, and for the vast majority of the comic book industry, especially for the big two, it's all about reboots, crossover events, limited runs, and alternate universe versions of characters. Now, manga isn't completely free of this, but in most cases it's usually a spinoff or a sequel series, and not just a straight up reboot of the original story. So it's much easier to just ignore that stuff. It's very clear which one the main series is. Another thing to mention for accessibility is the price point. Manga volumes are cheap. Most retailers sell them for less than 10 bucks. Hell, for some popular series, you can get them for as low as like 7. And know what you get? About 200 pages and several chapters of the story. But if physical isn't your thing, digital is also an option, as well as subscription services. It's easier than ever to start reading manga. Comics, on the other hand, are usually more expensive for a lot less pages. A single issue could only be, what, 10 to 15 pages, but cost more than a volume of manga. Of course, there is a bit of a reason for this. Comics are usually fully colored, and usually printed on thicker paper, so it costs more. But look at it from the consumer's perspective. Do I spend 10 bucks for 200 pages and multiple chapters of a story, or do I spend the same amount or more for about 15 pages of a story? The answer is pretty clear there. The next thing I want to mention is variety. Manga has so many different types of stories with dozens and dozens of genres. If there's a niche you're into, odds are there's a manga about it. They got everything from action to romance to horror to crime thrillers to fantasy to historical fiction to hell, fucking food. It's got you covered. And you don't get that variety with American comics. Not saying stories like that don't exist or never existed, but you really gotta dig to find them. These days, most American comics are the standard affare that don't really bring anything new to the table. There are some smaller companies and indie stuff that do, but it's either very well hidden or it's not produced on the same scale as manga, only having like a few stories in that niche. Now, this isn't to say that manga doesn't have genre issues, because it does. Isekai is such an oversaturated market, but there's still a wide variety to pick from, and so it's easier to ignore the stuff that you don't like. And I guess this kind of goes with the next topic, creativity. This pairs with variety because not only are there many different types of genres of manga, but many more types of stories, some with concepts that wouldn't even be considered in American comics. Manga seems way more willing to experiment with different types of stories and storytelling methods. Now, of course, there are a lot of similarities between stories and different mangas. I mean, if you look at some of the top shonen in recent times, they share some similar aspects, or just straight up pull from previous shonen stories. Like, look at Demon Slayer, Jujutsu Kaisen, and Chainsaw Man. They're all stories that involve slaying demons, or devils, or curses, whatever you want to call them. They each have an organization within the story that the heroes work with to kill these demons slash devils slash curses. But the world, pacing, characters, setting, and power system is what really sets them apart. So yeah, on the surface, they're about a teenage protagonist killing and demons, but clearly the stories are very different from each other. But of course, there are some stories that are just copy and paste versions of each other. Isekai really has this problem, like I already mentioned. But then of course, there are a lot of stories that are just on the complete opposite spectrum. They really have no ties to other stories. But as a whole, as far as creativity is concerned, manga has it, and stories that can appeal to whatever you're looking for. And now the last big thing I want to talk about is a bit of a hot topic, and one I usually avoid on the channel, because it can really get people going, but it's hard to avoid it when talking about modern comics, and that's fucking politics. American comics have had this fascination with just using comic book characters as their mouthpieces to regurgitate whatever social or political opinion they might have. Their focus isn't on telling a good story, it's on preaching to the readers in the most up its own ass way possible. They would rather use these legendary characters to spill whatever ideology they have onto the page, instead of using that time and energy to make an interesting character or a compelling narrative. Or instead of trying to think of clever ways to put in pieces of what they believe into the story, they instead will just resort to strawman arguments represented by a character in the story who you're supposed to hate, and then making their self-insert MC the one that's always right and preaches their message. And they're gonna be damned if they're gonna let things like good storytelling or character development get in the way of that. Now on the flip side, in manga, it appears that the story and characters come first, and if there are political messages or ideas in the story, it's interwoven throughout the narrative and not just shouted at you from out of nowhere by a character. People don't like being preached at or being made to feel dumb, and manga authors seem to understand this, at least much more than Western writers do. And so in turn, they put their focus in the stuff that people actually enjoy, you know, like the characters, the story, the action, the world building, you know, little stuff like that. And now this seems to be the biggest reason people stopped reading American comics, at least in the past 5 to 10 years or so, because these characters just become mouthpieces for the writers to push whatever message they want and not actually care about the readers. Now this section might have made some people uncomfortable because politics suck, but it's the truth. American comic writers care more about their own political opinions than they do about the stories and characters they write, and more importantly, they care more about it than the readers. They preach and demonize others, ruin characters and stories, then expect you to pay for it. Now those are some of the main reasons why manga is just curb stomping American comics. Alright, so what's funny is, as I was writing this section, I came across this video here. There's a new Suicide Squad anime that's literally called Suicide Squad Isekai. It looks like DC is saying fuck it and partnering with Wit Studio to make it, which is pretty interesting because DC's animated movies have been pretty underwhelming, and their shared animated universe was a pretty mixed bag. So them partnering up with a Japanese studio to make an anime is pretty interesting, though this isn't their first time doing something like this. There was also that Batman Ninja movie that I thought was pretty lackluster, though this won't be made by Wit Studio, so I have much more faith that it'll probably be good. Still kind of funny, that's all. It's almost like if you can't beat them, join them. Now, I actually had a theory and wanted to test it, so I put out this poll here, asking which is better, American comics or manga, and unsurprisingly, comics won. But that was gonna happen, cause you know, I built my channel on comic book media, so that was expected. If you went to an anime-focused channel like Totally Not Mark and asked the same exact question, you'll have the opposite results. But that actually wasn't the test. That's right, I deceived you. The actual test is this part right here. It's why you think that. In this case, why did the majority of people pick comic books? Now, the reason I asked this is because over the years, after the explosion of popularity with comic book movies, I've been noticing that despite how popular the movies are, not many seem to really buy or even read the comics. And so I came to three main reasons for this. Number one, people just like the characters at this point. Even if they read a lot of comics in the past, they more than likely don't read the current runs. I have a friend who loves Spider-Man and Batman, and has read his fair share of comics, but he doesn't read the newer material at all. Yeah! Number two, people like the character from other forms of media, like video games, movies, and shows, and that's how they're familiar with them, and don't engage with the source material. These are the people who were first introduced to the characters by one of those forms of media and became a fan, which to be fair is how most of us got into it, but they don't read comics and just prefer to stick to the movies and shows. This makes up a lot of the quote-unquote normies you see comic book fans talking about. And reason number three, people just like the idea of the characters or heroes. Now the most extreme examples of this are the people on Twitter who like the idea of a gay Robin or a gay Superman. So they'll share and retweet it when they see that it's announced, but won't actually go out of the way to purchase it. And so the run sells poorly and gets canceled. This literally happened just recently with three different comic runs. One with a bisexual Tim Drake, another with a bisexual Superman, then there's that Batgirl run that everyone forgot about. You see, these type of people are the most annoying, because they'll scream to the high heavens about why this character is important and how they're gonna be amazing, but then won't bother to read the damn thing when it comes out. And then they'll just move on to the next thing in a week or two. Now these reasons I just listed, to me, seem to be the main ones for why people prefer American comics or even like American comics these days. It's usually because they like the character because they used to like them in the past, or they really like the movies, video games, and TV shows, or they like the idea of the character. Now, in that poll I told you about, it got 1,100 votes, but less than 50 comments. So not many people were actually explaining why they picked comics over manga. And the majority of the comics were what I predicted. People picking comics because they like the characters more, usually because they like their older runs from decades ago, or they like the character from the movies and TV shows. But even they acknowledge that the current state of comics are kind of shit, and even point out the same various issues that I just did. Although I will mention that others did admit that they pick comics because they aren't familiar with manga or anime in general. But after looking through all these comments, it's safe to say that my theory wasn't too far off. Most people seem to only pick comics just because they love the older runs, and they just really like the character. Now, I do want to apologize for tricking you guys and using you as an example, but you guys being big fans of comics and comic book media made you guys the right test subjects for this experiment, so I thank you for participating. Wow, this section went on longer than expected, so let's move on to something else. Long story short, reject American comics, embrace manga. Now what's the fat ass nut? So besides anime, what else have I been into? Well, nothing much really. No new comic book projects interest me besides Invincible Season 2. And as far as new movies are concerned, the biggest thing I'm looking forward to is Rebel Moon from Zack Snyder. We recently got a full trailer, and I gotta say, the shit looks good. So they filmed both movies back to back, so we get part 1 this winter, and then part 2 next year. And I think Netflix is really banking on this being the next big franchise. Not only do they have two movies coming out, but they're already planning on making an animated series, as well as some prequel comic books coming out. Those actually might suck considering who's writing them, but it's clear that this is the next big thing for Snyder, because he spent the last 2 years working on them, and I'm excited for it to finally come out. Now, I was a bit worried about the CGI, because this is a big sci-fi epic, and Netflix special effects can look pretty good or pretty bad, but luckily, this one looks good. And I think it was a smart move to have this as its own franchise, and not attached to anything else, like how it originally was planned. If you didn't know, Snyder pitched this to Lucasfilms back in 2012 as a Star Wars movie, but they obviously declined it, and then they were bought by Disney. So I think having it as its own thing, with its own universe, give Snyder much more freedom. So yeah, Rebel Moon, the shit looks good and I'm excited for it. And besides that, there's also that new David Fincher film that's also coming to Netflix. It's Fincher, the guy like never misses, so I'm really looking forward to it. And of course, there's Aquaman 2 like I mentioned earlier. And honestly, that's about it. I've been kind of just cut off from whatever's happening in the world and just doing my own thing. I've completely checked off from comic book media in general, and most of my time is spent watching anime and hitting the gym. And I know I built my channel off of comic book shit, but I really have no interest in it anymore. It's gone completely downhill and I'm just not interested. And I know there are several people who've actually told me personally that they're very much interested in hearing me talk about other things besides comic book shit. But honestly, man, I don't really enjoy the video making process that much anymore, so I still really appreciate you guys for saying that and encouraging me to still make videos just about other topics. I'm just kind of burnt out on it. I mean, on this channel alone, I did, what, over 300 videos in 3 years? Just at this point in my life now, I don't feel like I really have it in me anymore. I'm enjoying my peaceful existence. But if the mood strikes me, I might come back and make a one-off video, but it definitely won't be any consistent schedule. Yeah, I don't really have shit else to say. I think that'll do it for this video. That's really what I've been up to and my thoughts on current comic book shit. If you made it this far into the video, I want to thank you for listening to all my fucking ramblings, and I want to apologize for being absent without really saying a word. I am on Instagram if you want to follow me there. I just kind of post random shit, so give me a follow there if you want. Yeah, so I think that will about do it, so thanks again for watching, and maybe I'll see you in the future. Peace. No diamonds in it, Swiss moving, no time for ticking. Introverted, not trying to kick it. Private life, please mind your business. Introverted these days, introverted these days. Plain Jane, not in chain lanes. Plain Jane, not in chain lanes. Plain Jane, not in change lanes. Plain Jane, not in change lanes.
That's it? That's your base extremist Discord server? That was just schizo ramblings and Japanese hentai!
Understand why I had to punish you earlier?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Homosexual!